Session was particularly useful because they kind of broke it down quite simply, like simply just told you exactly what they do, how they got there, and kind of how they failed in a sense to get where they are.
Today I was on a panel earlier. It went really well, some really good people. It's really good to give back to some people that are interested in getting into the career that I'm in at the moment. I think this event is wicked.
I think it's really important for the industry to support events like this, and it's great to see so many people from across the record industry and the live side and managers here today, because there are so many young people who either want to be artists or songwriters or producers or who want to work in the industry, and it's important for them to understand how this sometimes slightly complicated business works.
I knew there was going to be loads of networking going on. I knew I came alone, but I know so much people were here.
The panel went really well. Everyone was responsive. Everyone seemed really interested. I got bombarded afterwards, which is always good. I think Industry Takeover is extremely important for people who are trying to find a way in this industry, be it an artist or on the other side of the industry, working in realms such as myself, in a label or in a big platform like GRM Daily.
The most useful session for me was the Women in Music Girls I Rate with Carla Marie session. It was, for me, it was so inspiring. It was absolutely incredible. These women know what they're talking about, and it was just great to see women championing other women.
As females, I feel like we're so strong together, perhaps in a way that men aren't, because a lot of the time we react with emotion, which can be a detriment, but also I think that's one of our strengths. So when you have a group of females that are working together, we have the foresight of not only emotion, but of strength and power and courage as well.
Today at the Industry Takeover event, I was on a panel with Girls I Rate. We was upstairs talking about females in the industry and what obstacles that we overcome and stuff. And I also performed downstairs, and that was really, really dope. Really had a great time.
Please just get out my face. Now you crave my space.
I think the only thing that's really changed now is that the gatekeepers who are now like 30, 40, is that they've grown up with grime, so they don't see it as just a bunch of angry black kids on stage.
I think the most useful session to me has been the grime talk. I just thought it was really educational. There were some big names there talking about their experiences and their lives. If only you knew the burns that I suffer. If only you knew.
On the one-to-one A&R sort of sessions, the main point was making sure that the artists understand who their target audience are, where their music should be going, what platforms, how important streaming is, and kind of making sure they're branded in the right way to go forward and release music.
Some days I'll tell myself that I could take a
ride. So I think the most influential part is just talking to people, just communicating, patterning up and smiling.
So events like this create awareness for those that are in the music industry, those that are interested in being in music, and obviously speaking to the right people, networking. And I feel like networking in this day and age, especially with the social media outburst that we have, is a very, very, very good outlet and a very, very good way to, you know, create business ventures.
This event is about politics. This event is doing more good than traditional politics could ever hope for, because it's engaging real people, young people, in something meaningful.
It actually like helps me as an artist to understand the scene and see things differently and see it through an artist's perspective.
Building teams and knowing more people will allow all of us to take over from the normal mainstream industry.